Now, I've stumbled upon this guy who's got a really tasty Jeep for sale. From the pictures, the car he's selling looks really good. He's got it up for $15,500, which is a bit more than I wanted to pay, but it's got the all-important MB designation, which means it's a genuine army vehicle. Yes, I'm ringing about the car you got for sale. The World War II Jeep. I suppose the important question is rust. OK then, Terry, that's great. All right, mate. Cheers. Bye-bye. Wow. Now, Terry sounds like the real deal. And if the car is anywhere near as good as it looks in the pictures, it's definitely worth a visit. It's not too far away from here, so it's time to hit the road. Underneath a tarpaulin, that's always a nice thing to come and see. See the surprise? Oh, look at that! I tell you what, that is fantastic. Do you know, on the pictures, I was kind of thinking it wouldn't measure up, and now I've got here and I can see it, it's better than I would have hoped. So tell us a little bit about the Jeep.
It's a 1945 Willys MB. This was the main production line Jeep from 1942 to 1945.
And that's the one that everyone wants, isn't it? The authentic Second World War Willys Jeep.
Absolutely.
What's borrowed time written on the side for?
I'm selling the Jeep for a friend of mine, and this logo right here was what was on his father's Jeep in the Philippines during World War II.
Kidding.
His father was a surgeon for the Army.
Oh, that's fantastic. Mm-hmm. So a little bit of history has come along with the previous owner.
Right.
I love that. Very, very nice. And these are great, aren't they, on the side? That's unexpected. You've got an axe and a shovel?
Right. The Jeep's a very utilitarian type vehicle. You're going to find things like this all over the vehicle. And the axe and shovel was one of the most obvious tools that they put on it. And that's why it's displayed here.
It looks amazing. Is it okay to have a look under the hood?
Right, you need to pull up those latches off of there.
Oh, yes. Oh, look at that. That's fantastic. You could eat your dinner off of that, couldn't you?
Right, that's a 65 horsepower flathead four-cylinder motor called the L-Block, top-of-the-line rebuild. You have about a $7,500 plus motor in this
Jeep. You're kidding.
You could basically balance a quarter on this thing.
Seriously,
yeah, oh,
that's fantastic. And I love some of this. This is great. What's this for?
Well, that's the lube order chart, which is always put in most of all the Jeeps during World War II so that the GI in the field could see where to lubricate the vehicle. And on the back is the trailer that goes behind the Jeep.
That's brilliant, isn't it?
It is.
So you were sent off with your vehicle and a lube chart so
right.
you could look after it.
Right.
So I can't help for the life of me think what's wrong with it because it looks in such good order.
Well, it is a nice Jeep. However, there are some drawbacks, and the floor is one of the most obvious issues on the vehicle itself. Over time, someone's let the body bolts get loose in the floor, and so the floor was jiggling around and it cracked the floor. So someone's put their own version of a stiffener in here.
Right, so these two big round discs, they're not original.
They're not original
to the somebody's
vehicle.
Put those in to sandwich the body to the chassis.
That's correct.
I gotcha. That's a big job, isn't it? Because you're gonna have to cut this floor out. That's gonna be a big thing. The seat's tatty as well,
isn't
it?
Seat cushions are definitely tired on the rear, at least.
Yeah, yes. Okay. But it's lovely, isn't it? Because it's got all the bits that you need to survive right here within the Jeep. I just noticed this little tire pump and the jerry can.
Right. Now, jerry can shouldn't be mounted in the floor like this. This is not the correct spot. The jerry cans were typically mounted off the back of the rear panel to the other side of the tire right there.
That needs to be reinstated over there.
Yeah.
Does it have a hood that
it
comes
does.
With it?
The top is located under the passenger seat.
Look at that. Brilliant. Okay, yeah. It's fantastic. Do you know what? I love it. I think it's very, very charming. And I can't wait to get it out on the road. Any chance of a test drive?
Absolutely. Go ahead and jump on in. We'll fire up.
Now, I know I should be taking this seriously, but come on. I'm getting a bob around in a 70-year-old Jeep in this amazing countryside. Living a dream or what? OK, well, first impressions. Well, it may be a 70-year-old machine, but the engine, it's as sweet as a nut. It's got a 2.2-litre Willys engine. Most of them had Ford units, but the Willys is more desirable back in the UK. It runs just like a Swiss watch, just like Terry says. The other thing I'm getting from the Willys is that it's pretty decent to drive. It sits on the road really nicely. And because it's short and lightweight, it means it's pretty maneuverable too. In fact, I reckon I could point it at any part of this landscape and it would just plow through it. However, there's a but, because there's always a but. There's a problem with a gearbox. It's a struggle to get it into third gear, and Terry is asking top dollar for this Jeep, and that is a black mark against this. So now I have to decide whether this Jeep is for me, and frankly, it is. However, Terry is asking $15,500, which is a bit more than I wanted to spend. So I'm gonna use this gearbox problem as a lever, if you pardon the pun, to get him down on price. Well, that was an entertaining test drive.
You like that, huh?
I did like it. It's not fast, is it?
No, it's not the fastest thing in the world.
But it's charming, and I love that open feeling when you're driving it down the road. Kind of felt like a bit like a GI, to be honest with you.
Kind of expected that.
Just need to lose a few pounds. I love it, but it's not without its faults. There's the problem with the floor at the back, and there's a problem with the transmission. There's a crunch in third gear, and I'm sure because of its age, it's going to have its other little problems. But saying all that, I really like it, so I was going to make you an offer.
Okay.
You've advertised it for how much?
$15,500.
$15,500. I've got the figure of $12,000 in my head.
Well, Mike, that's a nice enough offer, but it's just shy of the mark. This Jeep is really worth more than $20,000 in a good market, which is pretty close to turning around right now.
Well, I'll push it to $12,500.
I tell you what, make it 13 and it's yours.
Hold out your hand. Yes, I just bought myself a Willys Jeep. Click here to subscribe.